Do you know what's the game playing now? This is called Clash Royale, and if you've never heard of it, but probably you don't play a lot of mobile game because it's still in the top grossing game of all time. But personally, I've been playing it for at least 3 years, and this is not me playing right now, this is my little Python script running an AI that plays the game for me. And yes, if you hadn't figured it out, this video is all about how I automated playing Clash Royale. And I'm doing this because my previous video on how I automated playing some minigame in EVE Online was pretty popular, and after I did that with machine learning, I wanted to learn more about machine learning, and I thought I might be able to implement something called reinforcement learning inside Clash Royale. To be honest, I never quite got to that point because, yeah, it's more difficult than I thought, and I never actually managed to implement a machine learning algorithm inside Clash Royale. But I'm still going to talk to you about how and why and how far I got, because I did manage to get an AI that could farm crowns for what used to be the clan war. I think it's become quite useless now, but it would still be interesting as a platform to finally implement some machine learning, and I really would like to go back to that eventually. But as you'll see, there's quite a few issues that I just haven't quite figured out how to fix yet. Now, this is, I believe, against the terms of service of Supercell. So if you're planning to do that, probably don't use your main account and, you know, realize that Supercell might not be quite happy with what you're doing. So you've been warned, it's not my fault if something happened to your account. So if you're planning to make a script that will play a game for you, what's the first couple of issues that come to mind? Well, the first thing about Clash Royale is that it's an Android game, so you need a way to run it on your PC if you want to run some kind of scripts. I mean, there might be a way to do it through ADB, which is the Android debugger, but turns out there's a much easier way than that called Bluestacks. Bluestacks is an emulator for Android that allows you to run pretty much any Android software on your PC. So if you download it and install it, it's free and you can just log into your Gmail account and go into the Play Store and download Clash Royale and then you're basically set to go. Of course, personally, if you're planning to do the AI like I did, you'll probably need to get to at least 1,600 trophies before you unlock all the cards that you need for the deck idea I had in mind. Basically, I wanted to do a beatdown deck. If you're not familiar with Clash Royale, there's a couple of different archetype of decks, and the beatdown is maybe for an AI the easiest to figure out, I thought, because you can kind of basically ignore what your enemy is doing and just like go in with your combo and hope that your combo will just annihilate the enemy. Where the other archetype require a little bit more finesse. But even before we get into the AI part, I needed my script to just be able to play the game. Just basically know where the cards are, how much mana it has, which screen it's on, which button it has to press. And this is much harder than it looks, because, for example, take Alpha Star.
And Cyril, having not done enough damage with this all in, in a dire situation, just immediately counterattacking. And that's it. As Cyril sees it coming, he knows that there is no way to stop Alpha Star.
It looks awesome. It's amazing. It can beat the top player at StarCraft. But it also uses an API. It doesn't need to understand the actual pixels on the screen. It's just communicating directly with the game engine. My game doesn't do that. Clash Royale doesn't have an API for machines to learn from it. So I needed a way to be able to identify which screen I'm on, where the buttons are, and a lot of other information about what's happening in the game at the moment. Some of these I have a couple of quick tricks that I implemented. For example, to know which screen I'm on, I just find a pixel on the screen that is a specific color for that screen. For example, in the start screen, the battle yellow button is a very specific color at a very specific location, and there's no other screen that has this color at this location. So I just check this pixel, and if it matched the color, then I know I'm on the battle screen and I can click the battle button. And same in the victory screen, there's only in the victory screen that you have the crown that's yellow, kind of in the middle top part of the screen. So I just check the color here to see if it's yellow, and I know I'm in the victory screen. Same thing again with all the screen. What is nice with this is that it's incredibly fast and incredibly performant. The disadvantage is that every time the resolution change or that there's an UI update that changes the colors, then I kind of have to do it all over again. And yeah, it happened more time than I would like to admit. And even to do this video, I had to spend like 2 days fixing my AI because it's been such a long time that everything had changed. So this little color trick allowed me to figure out which screen I'm on, which allows me to start the game, the action phase. Then there's a lot of stuff to figure out while I'm in the action phase. The first thing is, how much mana do I have to play my cards? And for this, I use exactly the same trick. I just look at the color on different points on the mana bar, and if the red component is high, then I know it's pink and it's full, and if it's low, and I know it's, you know, basically empty. Where it's a little bit more complicated is for the cards you have in your hand. Here I have no choice, I can't use color tricks like for everything else. I had to do some kind of pattern matching. Thankfully, OpenCV has a very nice and very fast way of looking up image inside another image. So I use this with reference cutout of each of the cards I have to figure out which one I have in my hands. The problem with that is it's still kind of slow, and when you're running an algorithm in real time, each frame of analyzing cannot take more than like 0.5 seconds, otherwise your reaction time will be way too slow when you need to play a card. So what I ended up doing is that besides just using the pattern matching of OpenCV, I'm also using NumPy to cut out only the part where I know the cards are, reducing the size of the image and reducing the size of the image I'm looking for kind of helps making it faster, and it still works pretty well. The final challenge, in the current implementation at least, is figuring out what units are on the board. And this one is a biggie. I still haven't gotten a perfect solution, but I've gotten much better at it. My first idea was to take the sprite sheet, so I went into the APK and I managed to extract all the sprites that the game has. But I realized that Clash Royale has a lot of sprites. And it's kind of hard. Like I said, pattern matching is pretty slow, so I can't just go through all the potential sprite of all the potential units and try to find them on the board. It's just not gonna work. It's just too slow. So what I figured I would do is that I could maybe compare a screenshot of the empty game board with a screenshot of the current game board to isolate each unit. Figuring that if I subtract the two image, what's gonna be left is only the units. But that doesn't quite work either, because it turns out that maybe you've never noticed, but the game board is actually animated. There's sometimes like clouds or water flowing or stuff like that. So it means that I always end up with some garbage, and it makes analyzing the difference really hard. Plus, if a unit has kind of similar colors to the background, then it ends up just disappearing altogether. So yeah, that wasn't working so well. And then one of my friends noticed that every enemy unit has its level printed in red above its head. So instead of having to pattern match for all the units in the game, I just need to pattern match for a number between 1 and 9 written in red. And that's surprisingly fast, and it allows me to know with very precise positioning where every enemy unit are. And right now that's what I'm doing. It still doesn't allow me to know which unit it is, but at least I know where it is and which level it is, which can be kind of helpful in making decision about which card to play and where to play them. Basically, with just these three little pieces of information, how much mana, which card I have, and how many units are on the board, I started implementing what I call my dumb strategy. And I call it the dumb strategy because it's actually not machine learning, it's just a bunch of if. And even as far as ifs goes, it's probably some of the worst thing I've ever done in my life. It basically does three things. Play cards until it has giant balloon. Then once it has giant balloon, wait until it gets 10 manas and play the giant balloon at the bridge. And with this, honestly, it's nearly guaranteed to get at least one crown. It will usually get 3 crown right after that, but it will take 1 tower down, at least. And that was my objective. I just wanted it to guarantee it could take 1 crown before it dies. And it kind of works like that. But from this, I was really hoping to get into reinforcement learning. So I started studying how to do it, and I was familiar with scikit-learn and scipy, so I wanted to try to do it in scikit-learn. But it turns out that scikit-learn is not really made for reinforcement learning, but I still tried to hack it into doing reinforcement learning, but yeah, in the end it never really worked. And part of it is definitely because I should have been using something else, like TensorFlow, maybe. But part of it is also because I don't think I have enough information for good AI to emerge from the neural network. I think I need a couple more information about the state of the board. For example, I really need to know which units are on the board, not just where they are. And I also need to know how much time there's left, because when you go into overtime, you should really prioritize taking any tower and making sure that your tower doesn't get destroyed. But while you're in the normal regular time, it's kind of fine to lose a little bit of health on your towers. So this strategy plays a part, and I don't know how to extract the time. I would need another machine learning, maybe, just to recognize the characters of the timer. And another part of the strategy, of course, is knowing if you've managed to take down the tower or how many health there is left on your own tower, and that's also not implemented. It's even more difficult because the towers won't show their health until they've taken some damage. So you don't know if the tower is healthy or destroyed because you don't have that information. Anyway, I'm not quite sure how I would do it. If I could somehow manage to get this information, maybe I would think about going back and trying to implement the reinforcement learning, maybe learning some TensorFlow, but right now it's just too much work and it's not really that useful, really, let's be honest. But anyway, I just wanted to show you guys this cool AI that plays Clash Royale, and I hope you liked it. And also, I would really appreciate if you hit the like button and the subscribe, because we're getting really close to 1,000 subscribers, and I just can't believe how amazing you all are. So thank you so much, and see you guys in my next episode. Bye!